Hello, Klaus here. Here is a super quick little video. It seems like we're doing some kind of a Star Wars theme this week. By Monday, I showed you how you could import a 3D model into DaVinci Resolve. And you can have a look at that right up here. And also on Wednesday, I showed you how to make a PNG TIE fighter fly, and you can have a look at that again up in the top corner. In this video, I'm just going to show you a super simple way of making a TIE fighter shoot lasers. So let's just pop into Fusion super quickly. So here we are in Fusion, and again, this is pretty similar to the thing I built on Monday. I have here my TIE fighter, and that is pointed in, and if you want to know more about how to do that, you can check out Monday's tutorial. Again, here I have a background, which is this thing, and this is resized to fit my timeline, and then it just merged together with the 3D model, and then that has an animation going on right here. So what I want to do now is I want to add in lasers from my TIE fighter. So first off, we're going to find a particular spot where we want our TIE fighter to shoot. So the way we're going to do this is actually just by dragging in another background node, which is right here. And I think this is a low budget way of doing this. I think you could do something in 3D space, but we are going to take the TIE fighter from the 3D space and merge that into our 2D scene. And then on top of that, we're going to make our laser blast or our laser effect. So again, here we have a background. I'm going to take in a polygon, and I'm just going to connect that here. And then I am going to use Control, push that down in the middle wheel on your mouse to zoom. Just make things a little bit easier sometimes. So again, I'm going to draw in a line here. I'm going to zoom out just a little bit, so I can kind of, you know, figure out what angle this shot should be in, something like that, I think. So we'll make something like this. I'm going to make this into a shape here, and then, you know, I can control it and make it smaller, something like that, maybe. And now you think this looks very strange, and indeed it does. But of course, we are going to merge this on top of our 3D to 2D thing here. So I'm just going to take in a merge node, going to drag that down here. I'm going to release that. And then if I push the second mouse button and drag this and let go, I'm going to make this to my foreground. Okay. And now we have a black line here. Doesn't look too good, doesn't look flattering or anything, but if I go into the background and I go up to the inspector, I could change the color. In this case, let's change it to a greenish color like that. I'm going to say okay, and now we have a laser beam. Still, this looks a little bit ugly. So to make this look a little bit better, we are going to select polygon. And then we'll go into the inspector of our polygon. And then if we go into our soft edges, we can make the edges way soft. I'm going to zoom in just a little bit here. A little bit out here. As you see, we can make this super soft, or we can find a place where it actually looks good. And then we can go into the border width as well, and we can change that around, something like that. So if we just go out of this, we now have a beam here. And you know, this might work, but I still want to do a little thing here. I'll go into the polygon again. I'm going to, you know, move this up a little bit, like so. And if I go down to the merge here, in my merge 2 node, I have a blend mode. So what I want to do at this particular time in our composition here, I want there to be a laser blast right here. So if I go into the blend and put in a keyframe, and then use the arrow keys to go, let's say, a frame back, or let's say 2 frames back, and then I'm going to push this to 0, and then I'm going to go 1, 2 frames forward, and now I'm at the first frame, so I'll go 2 frames more, like I'll go 1 frame more, I think that's better. Let's see, 2 frames more, and then I'm just going to put the blend down. So now we have this little effect here. You know, and that's how you could do this effect super easy. You know, and then we can continue by going forward and figure out where we actually want our thing to be. So we have one blazer shot here. Maybe I want another one right here. So the fastest way to do another one would be to highlight my polygon and my background note. And I'm simply going to push Control C, and then I'll click at the grid and Control V. And now I have done a copy of my laser effect. I'm then going to put in another merge note right here. I'm going to connect my background and polygon to the merge again the same way and add this in as a foreground. So here we have our second laser beam. And if I go to the polygon, I can now reposition a laser beam like that. And then, you know, I'll do the exact same thing, going into the merge and then simply going into the blend, adding a keyframe, going a couple of frames back, taking away my laser blast, going 2 frames forward, and let's just take it 2 frames more in front and then just blend it off. So now we have this little thing. And you know, if you add in the sound of the laser, you have a pretty nice effect. If you do need a laser sound, feel free to take my free laser sound. Link is down in the description. Anyway, this was just a super quick video, and I do hope you found it useful. If you did, please hit that subscriber button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it would help them out. And if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on this channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.